When I look back, I've had the privilege of beginning to work with something that was a movement, and now it is a well-established industry. And I think what makes me the most proud about community hospice is that we are a trusted and essential asset for our system of medical care. And we are also a charity that is supported widely by our entire community.
When people saw the reality of what we were doing every day and facing every day and what people needed, they were very, very anxious to help us.
I was a social worker who had just graduated from FSU, and I was working at the Council on Aging in St. Augustine, and two nurses asked to see me, never met the ladies before, and they said, "We really want to bring hospice care to this community, but the Jacksonville office doesn't have the money to provide any staffing here, and we have every discipline that we need except a social worker." And we thought, we'll ask. And I thought, okay, I'll do it for 3 months. And that was 1985.
Some of the people from hospice came and talked to us, and they were a very small organization at the time, and thought it would be useful for hospitals to be a part of that and its growth.
We founded what really is a community hospice. Our hospitals are stakeholders and they're partners. And again, when I go around the country, people say, "How on earth did you do that? And how on earth has that lasted since 1999?
We both believe in the concept so dearly. And when Trudy would go out to ask for funding for the hospice program, especially the Hadlow Center, they believed. We just trusted, and we put a lot of trust in God, but this building wouldn't be here if it wasn't for this person.
Well, we all wear 1,000 hats. We really did.
I was here in 95 when we built the Hadlow Center, and I remember that we were moving out of rented space finally into our own home. But it also was very innovative to be able to say to the community, for those patients and families who do not have another option for a place to call home, now you have a home-like environment that has been built specifically for hospice care. It transformed hospice care in Northeast Florida.
While we were learning and doing these kinds of things, we were nursing. When people saw the reality of what we were doing every day and facing every day and what people needed, they were very, very anxious to help us.
You have a very diverse group of leaders. Some are business leaders, others are very healthcare oriented, some are community leaders, and when you bring all those people together, that's a great resource that we have that not many organizations have.
When I look now, the Tree of Life exists. We started that. The thrift store exists. We started that. The Concord, the anti-car show, we started that. And they have just continued and continued.
It would take hours to recount the acts of goodness and charity that have come our way. And to me, we owe that back. We owe something back to our community because they allowed us to exist and their support allows us to continue to exist.
When you look at PEDS care, the pediatric hospice services that we provide, or educational services or bereavement services, we are able to redeploy those proceeds into other services that really wouldn't make sense from a pure financial standpoint, but make a lot of sense from a community standpoint.
The leadership of the hospice has been really very visionary and able to see into the future and to do it in a way that was understandable.
We provide a way for our community to really make sure that everyone who's facing grief, loss, serious illness, an end of life, and even those who are aging and want to age with dignity, know that there's a place in an organization that will walk with them.
We're very proud of all the work we've done over the 40 plus years. What's exciting to me too is the direction that this organization is going forward.
We're a bigger organization, we're a complex organization, we have a lot more technology, but one thing that never changed, the heart has never changed. The vision and the mission and the heart is one thing that creates continuity throughout all of these years.